Hey boys and girls, and welcome to Bedtime Bible Stories here at Valley View Baptist Church. Tonight we're going to hear from Brother Daniel Richardson about two brothers.
Hey boys and girls, this is Brother Daniel, and tonight I'm going to be reading to you guys a story from Genesis chapter 4 about two brothers. So Cain and Abel were the first children ever born on earth. As Cain and Abel grew older, Adam and Eve told them about the great creator, God. The boys learned of their parents' beautiful, perfect garden home and their happiness there as they walked and talked to God face to face. They were also told of God's enemy, Satan, and how he entered the serpent and tempted them to disobey God. How sad it must have been to have to explain to their sons how they had failed God's test and thus sin had entered into the world and ruined everything. Adam and Eve wanted very much for their sons to love God, trust him, and try and please him. But because Cain and Abel had inherited a sin nature in their hearts from their father, they would get mad, fuss, fight, say unkind words, lie, disobey, think bad thoughts, say ugly words, etc., etc., just like we end up doing today. These things are certainly not pleasing to God. Adam and Eve were very careful to teach them about the blood sacrifice. Cain and Abel understood very clearly that they were to bring an animal offering to God in order to have their sins forgiven. As the boys grew up, they had jobs to do. Abel was a shepherd. He cared for the family's sheep. When a little lamb strayed away from the other sheep, Abel got it and brought it back. He cared for the sheep that got hurt. Abel knew his sheep very well. He probably had a name for each sheep in his flock. Cain's job was to help in the fields. He grew food for the family to eat. Cain probably used an old tree branch as a hoe to make some rows so the seeds could be planted. And then there were the weeds. Cain probably wondered why he had so many weeds to pull. Then he remembered what Adam and Eve, his parents, had told him. God said that there would be thorns and thistles in the ground because of their sins. Rocks had to be picked up and tossed aside. There was much bending over to clear the ground, to pull the weeds, and to even plant the seeds. Both Cain and Abel wanted to have their sins forgiven. The Bible tells us that Cain and Abel each built an altar upon which they would offer their sacrifices to God. Abel was very sorry for his sin. He wanted to be forgiven and to be right with God, so he chose his best lamb, killed it, shed its blood, and prayed, "Lord, I'm sorry for my sins. Please forgive me." God heard Abel's prayer and accepted Abel's offering. Fire came down from heaven to consume the lamb. Abel knew that God had forgiven him, and joy welled up in his heart. He was so happy because he had done things God's way. Cain also made an altar. He thought to himself, "I'm a farmer. I'll bring my best grain, vegetables, fruits, and nuts to the Lord as an offering." Of course, Cain knew that God had said an animal must be sacrificed, but he thought his fruit of the field would surely be acceptable to God. But God did not accept Cain's offering. Cain brought what he wanted to rather than obeying God. He tried to come to God in his own way. There was no blood in this offering. Cain sensed that God did not accept his offering, for no fire came from heaven to consume it. Cain was filled with rage because God had accepted Abel's offering and rejected his. God said to Cain, "Why are you so angry? Why is your face so downcast? If you bring the right kind of offering, I will accept you. Why don't you go get a lamb for the offering right now?" But Cain was so angry, he would not listen. No doubt Adam and Eve and Abel all tried to talk to him, but he kept on being angry at God and at his parents, and he was insanely jealous of Abel. Cain was not only angry, but he sulked and pouted. He scowled and frowned, poked out his lip, and wouldn't talk to anybody. All the time he kept telling Abel, "You're God's pet, his favorite, because he accepted your offering, but he wouldn't take mine." Abel said, "You know that's not true, Cain. Go over there to the flock. Get a little lamb and offer that to God as a sacrifice. He'll accept that." Cain replied, "I won't do it. If God doesn't take what I'll bring, then that's too bad." One day, when Abel was out in the field, Cain went out and picked a fight with him. He accused him of all sorts of untrue things and shouted at him at the top of his voice. He had such hatred in his heart and was so angry that he killed him, his own brother. We don't know whether it was a club, a knife, or a sharp rock, but Cain committed the first murder, a horrible crime against God and men. Have you ever heard anyone say, "I was so mad I could have killed him"? That's what the Bible says. If we keep hatred in our hearts, it eventually can lead to murder. God warns us very, very solemnly about this. Cain looked in horror at what he had done to his brother. He was terrified and said, "Oh, look what I've done. I've killed him. I've got to get out of here quick before God and my parents find out what I've done. I must run far away." That's exactly what Adam and Eve had tried to do, hide from God and cover up their sin. But no matter what we do or where we go, we cannot get away from God's all-seeing eye. So as Cain ran across the field, God called to him, "Cain, Cain." Looking up and shielding his eyes, Cain said, "Yes." God said, "Where is Abel, your brother?" Cain replied, I don't know," thinking he could fool God. Then in a flippant, sassy way, he said, "Am I my brother's keeper?" He meant, am I my brother's nursemaid or babysitter? He was irreverent and disrespectful to God. Imagine speaking like that to a holy and just God. The Lord said, "Cain, what have you done? You've killed your brother Abel, and now I will have to punish you. You must leave home and your family. From now on, you will be a fugitive and a vagabond, forever running for your life. You can never settle down anywhere. You will just wander from place to place." "My punishment's greater than I can bear. It's too hard," cried Cain. "You've driven me from my farm and from you and made me a runaway and a tramp. Everyone who sees me will try to kill me." Cain felt very, very guilty. The Lord replied, "They won't kill you, because I will put a special mark on you as a warning that you are not to be killed. Also, that mark will always remind you and all who meet you that the results of sin will follow you everywhere you go." We can learn a valuable lesson from this, boys and girls. One sin always leads to another sin until they just pile up. Cain disobeyed God by bringing the kind of offering that he wanted to. He thought he could come to God his own way. Then he got mad and pounded and refused to come to God the right way. Next, he killed his brother Abel and lied to God about it. Instead of admitting his sin and being sorry, he was sassy to God. As far as we know, Cain never repented of his sins, because the Bible says Cain went out from the presence of the Lord. This is one of the saddest statements in all of the Bible. Cain is a picture of all those who try to come to our Father God some other way through Jesus Christ. Some people today said, or will say, that God will accept me if I just try and do my best, live right, help the poor, go to church, and do the best I can. No, that's man's way to try to get to heaven. To be accepted by God into heaven, we have to come his way. Jesus says, "No man comes to the Father but by me." Many will have to be banished from the presence of the Lord forever and ever because they will not accept Jesus as their Savior. The lamb which was killed and offered by Abel on the altar is a picture of our Lord Jesus, who offered himself as a sacrifice on the cross for our sins. Since Jesus is God and never sinned, he could take our sins upon himself and die on the cross to take the punishment for our sins in our place. As the lamb's blood was shed, so Jesus shed his blood on the cross. When we ask Jesus to be our Savior, the blood of the Lamb of God covers our sin. By trusting Jesus, we can have a clean heart before God and be ready to go to heaven. This is God's way of making us right with him. So boys and girls, tonight, I want to ask, have you asked Jesus Christ to forgive you of your sins? If not, tonight could be the night that you talk to your mom or your dad or your guardian with you, and you could finally come to know the Lord as your personal Savior.
Wow, thank you so much, Brother Daniel, on that wonderful lesson on the life of Cain and Abel. Hey, thanks for joining us, and we'll see you guys Monday. Good night.